JWA 501. This is a photograph of SONGS, which is the San Onofre Nuclear Generating Station in San Clemente, California. And as I have pointed out many times, they're pushing to restart unit number 2 of this crippled plant. And yet, in their parking lot, they have solar panels on their lights. So I'm going to go back into the NRC public meeting, public forum regarding the concerns on the restart. And so it's not very clear, but bear with me.
That was clear. All right, thank you. Richard McPherson.
Thank you, sir. How many people in this room would be afraid to go to Fukushima Daiichi and wander around on site? Would you please raise your hands? Okay, thank you very much. Some of you have heard me before. I'm a resident of this area. I've been in nuclear power since 1963. I have had people, that friends of mine that have worked at SONGS, and qualified under me that became senior reactor operators at SONGS. Last week I was at Fukushima Daiichi, where I got close and I didn't die. There are...
It's not like you're going to drop folks, over dead immediately.
Folks, listen, let's be considerate and let them finish, okay?
Yeah, let the buffoon finish.
Please.
Like the workers at San Onofre, the workers there are working to restore their plants and their areas. I have all the faith in the world in the workers at San Onofre. Why don't you ask yourselves, why do they go to work every day? Do they go to work every day because they're trying to make a problem for them and their families? No.
No, because they're not being told the truth.
Like anybody else, and they have a safe plant. The plant has always been operated safely, and it's been shut down as it should have been when they had the leak, as has every other plant in the United States. If you take the NRC coupled with the industry in the United States, we have the safest safety record in the world, bar none. I come from naval reactors where I spent 20 years before I went on the commercial side and I went international, and we are the gold standard. So I know what it takes to operate and maintain plants safely. And I used to laugh at what you anti-nukes say. I used to think it was funny, but it's tragic. Because you're hurting millions of people. In the San Diego, pardon me? In the San Diego and LA area, there are perhaps 50,000 people that have a lifeline allowance that depend on electricity to live.
And if they're doing fine without SONGS operationing right now.
Can you just let him finish? Okay,
this guy is such a joke that he's being booed off.
Listen,
it doesn't have to be a question.
Just let the man finish, okay?
And Richard, if you could wrap up for us, please.
So some of those people, they depend on having electricity within 2 hours. So why don't you step back in a minute and think about all the people at the NRC.
Hey, you know,
thank you very much.
Let's let him finish.
Yeah, he's done. He's done.
I have someone right here.
Thank you, Chip. I'm Glenn Pascal from the Sierra Club. I come from a family of engineers. I have a lot of respect for the professionalism and effort that those on the panel tonight have put into this issue. And I have a lot of respect for the passion and conviction of everyone from all sides, environmentalists, labor, citizens. We're all here with sincere convictions. And since we're supposed to ask questions instead of make statements, I'm going to put my statement in the form of a question, which is, does tonight perhaps suggest that the cattle have left the corral, that this issue has assumed dimensions of concern and uncertainty and conflict, that a dialogue among even the most highly qualified technical people cannot accommodate, and that if a restart decision emerged from that, the level of public outcry would be unmanageable and would create damage for the credibility of the NRC that the new chair, Allison McFarland, absolutely does not want because she's committed to an open process. So my question is, perhaps in fact is tonight Exhibit A, that something like the adjudicated license agreement process is really now inevitable. Thank you.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Glenn.
Let's go to...
Understand your comments.
Let's go to Caesar.
Hi, my name is Caesar Motz. I'm sorry, what?
We tried to explain that a couple of different ways that an adjudicatory hearing could be held. We don't have the authority here to make that decision. If we can, we can talk about those processes more.
So we take the comment.
Yeah. It depends on what process we're in. So we can.
Could be the commission.
Could be, like I said, could be the commission. It could be the SLB, some of the decisions they make and the action that would be taken as a result of that. The SLB is an independent body, yeah.
I can't hear the questions.
The process that we're in right now is a process that, as we thought we tried to explain,
Excuse me, because we're not in the
process that would result in a decision to hold the hearing.
Good evening. My name is Jennifer Massey. I've been a resident of San Clemente for 33 years. I live about 5 miles from San Onofre. And it's very nice you can assure us you won't allow a restart unless you determine it to be operated safely. The NRC and Edison always tell us safety is their number one concern. We contend that there are other critical considerations that preclude the possibility of the safety of millions of people. San Onofre is designed to withstand no more than a 7.0 earthquake. It's possible we could sustain one greater than 7.0. The tsunami wall is 14 feet at high tide. The wall of water at Fukushima ranged between 45 to 65 feet high. There is a possibility of fire, terrorist attacks, human failure. On top of all these circumstances, we all know evacuation is impossible. There is bound to be damage to the I-5, to some of the bridges, closing all the roads. There are almost 20,000 children in K-12 in just the Capistrano Unified School District alone. Buses, the school buses that are supposed to evacuate those children to the Orange County Fairground to meet their parents can handle less than 5,000. So that means one out of four kids gets to be on a bus. That's if the buses can get through. To top all of this are the thousands of tons of nuclear waste with no safe permanent repository, and a restart will only add to that liability. It's not just the fact we can't get insurance for our equities, which represent most people's nest eggs. It's also the fact that a radioactive plume could destroy California's agriculture and the supply of much of the nation's food. So, my question to you is, can you honestly say this plant, which sits on three earthquake faults, can be operated safely? Thank you.
Great question. And no, it...